Today's experiment, we are going to study the pH of for the given water samples and its clarity. First, we will be discussing about the pH of the water samples. We will be getting three different water samples, that is the distilled water, tap water and swimming pool water. Now, before we start with the experiments, we will first try to understand why there should be a detection of pH of different water samples. Now, the pH is nothing but the acidity or the basicity of the water. Now, this basicity or the acidity of the water will be decided based on the salts which are present in the soil. Now, apart from that, if there is a drastic change in the pH of the water samples, that will be due to the fertilizers that are being used, the pollutants, the sewage water that contaminates the soil, resulting into soil pollution. Now, for this experiment, we are going to use the three solutions. The first is the distilled water. Now, this particular distilled water we will be testing for the pH. The second one is the tap water, and the third water sample is the swimming pool water. Now, how we are supposed to perform this experiment? pH papers will be given to each and every student, and the students are supposed to dip the pH paper in the given solutions. Now, the first one is the tap water. The distilled water. Now, in a distilled water, there will be no change in the pH. Now, how you are supposed to detect the pH? Now, whatever the color which has been appearing onto the pH paper, just wave off the extra water, and this color you can match with the standard readings which are given on the pH papers cover. Now, if you try to match it, we are supposed to match the color on the pH paper along with the standard colors printed onto the cover of the pH papers. Now, this distilled water by default, it will have a 7 pH. If there is a slight change in the pH of distilled water, that means there is a contamination to the distilled water, or the beaker that we are using is not clean. Because of these two reasons, only the pH may vary, but by default we are supposed to write the pH for distilled water as 7, that is neutral, because it does not contain any dissolved salts in it. The second water sample is the tap water. Now, for this particular tap water, there will be slight change as per the distilled water, because this tap water is the water reservoir or the stored water from the dams or nearby lakes and ponds, and these will have some of the pollutants in it or any contamination to the water, so it will show a slight change in its pH. Now, this may come as 6 as per these readings. Now, the last one is the swimming pool water. Now, this swimming pool water, when you dip the pH paper in the swimming pool water, you will see that there is a sudden change in the color of the pH paper. That is, the pH paper has now changed to blue. That means this particular blue color indicates the alkalinity or the basicity of the water. So approximately it is 12 on the pH readings. So that means the swimming pool water is highly basic in nature. So this is how we can determine the pH, and based on the pH we can say that whether the water is polluted or it has been contaminated with any pollutants, and we can do the purification. Why we got the swimming pool water pH as 12? Because this particular water is being continuously purified, adding chlorine, and different methods are being done for the purification of this swimming pool water. So this is how we can determine the pH of the water sample for the given water samples using pH, and we can be safe from drinking the highly acidic water or highly basic water. Okay, the observations for the water samples for their respective pH values. We can prepare an observation table consisting of the different water samples. The first will be the distilled water, the pH will be 7, and the nature of water we can write neutral. Whereas the second is the tap water, it will be slightly basic or slightly acidic depending upon the readings that the students will note down, and the nature of water will be either slightly acidic or slightly basic. The third one is the swimming pool water. The reading in our today's practical we got is as 12. So under pH column we can note down the reading as 12, and under nature of water we can write it as basic. Depending upon whatever the observations we get in this experiment, we can do the conclusion part, that is, the pH of water is an indicator of impurities. The pure water has the neutral pH, that is the distilled water, and the reading is 7.
pH less than 7 indicates acidic nature and pH more than 7 indicates alkaline nature. So these will be your observations and conclusions, and then we will follow the second half of the experiment, that is the study of clarity of water samples. The second half of our experiment is to study the clarity of the water samples. Now this is the clarity of the water samples. The measuring of the clarity of water samples is an important part of the environmental science. Often the lake streams contain pollutants and the sediments that make the water cloudy. This often has a bad effect on the organisms that live in the water. Typical sources of turbidity in drinking water include the waste discharges, algae or the aquatic weeds, humic acids and other organic compounds resulting from decay of plants, leaves, etc. In water sources and high iron concentrations, which give water a rust color, red coloration. Now, in this particular experiment, we will be using a brown screen and we will be testing the water samples for its clarity. The first water sample that I am going to use is the distilled water. I will pass a source of light through the beaker to show you whether this water consists of any particularly suspended particles in it or not. Now how is it functions? Now when I am passing the light, a flash or a beam of light through the beaker, you can see that there is a sharp image getting formed on the screen. Now this sharp image is getting formed only and only because there are no suspended particles present inside the water sample. So therefore, distilled water is the clearest water sample, or you can say there is no turbidity in a distilled water sample, and in inference we can say that it is clear and transparent, or the standard liquid. The second water sample I will be using is the swimming pool water. Now in this swimming pool water there will be less turbidity. You can compare the two beakers, that in first, that is in distilled water, there was a sharp image getting formed on the screen. Now in the second water sample, that is the swimming pool water, there is less turbidity, water is less polluted and it is also clear, but the image which is getting formed is not perfect on the screen as compared to the distilled water. The third one is the tap water. Now in tap water, if the water sources are from the open lakes, ponds or the dams, then definitely there will be more sedimentation taking place, that is the particulate matters will be more, and hence the image that is getting formed is not clear as compared to the swimming pool water and the distilled water. So it will be more turbid as compared to distilled water and swimming pool water. So these are the three different water samples which we will be testing for the clarity. Now what after observations, what will be the conclusion? The conclusion will be a turbid water sample is less clear and more polluted. Hence, it is not suitable for consumption without treatment. Thus, the clarity of water sample indicates the degree of pollution in it. So, these are the two experiments under one heading, that is the study of pH of given water samples and its clarity.
After performing the experiment, now we will see how we are supposed to write the observation table for the study of water samples collected from different water bodies for their pH and clarity. Now in our board exams, that is the practical exams, we are supposed to prepare two separate observation tables, result and conclusion, for the said experiment, that is the study of water samples collected from different water bodies for their pH. So the observation, conclusion, result will be separate for pH and separate for clarity. So first we will see the observations for water samples for their pH. Now this is how we are supposed to prepare the observation table. There will be three columns. The first column will be water sample, then the pH and the nature. The water samples, the first will be the distilled water, the pH is 7, the nature will be neutral. Then the second water sample is tap water, pH is 6, it is slightly acidic.
And the third one is swimming pool water. The pH is 12 and the nature is alkaline. Now all these three water samples, the pH and nature, we have already performed the experiment and same readings have been written in the observation table. So now based on these observations, we can interpret the result as pH value of 6.5 to 7.5 is referred as more or less neutral. If the pH is less than 6.5, then the water is acidic. And if the pH is more than 7.5, it is alkaline or basic. Then comes the observation table for the water samples for their clarity. Now observe the clarity of distilled water, and then based on the clarity of distilled water, we can compare the same with the remaining two water samples, that is the tap water and swimming pool water, for its turbidity. Then for distilled water, there will be no turbidity because there will be no suspended particles, so no pollution. The tap water observation will be less turbid, or less turbidity is seen, few suspended particles will be present. And the third one is swimming pool water, moderate turbidity, more suspended particles will be seen, so less clarity in swimming pool water as compared to tap water, and there will be no turbidity in distilled water. The result for clarity will be the light gets scattered because of the particles present in water. More particles make water more turbid and it reduces the clarity. So this is the observation table for pH of water samples and clarity of water samples, followed by their respective results. Now from next slide onwards, there will be a discussion of questions which are given in HSC biology practical notebook, and those questions will be discussed, and these are the answers that we can write for it. The first question is, why is turbid water not suitable for consumption? Obviously there will be suspended particles. Now when we say suspended particles, the suspended particles may be from the dead and decaying animals, plants, microorganisms can be present. Now if we start consuming this kind of a water, then it will result into gastrointestinal diseases, and especially the problematic for immunocompressed people. Now what do you mean by immunocompressed people? Immunocompressed people are those people whose immunity is very low, and they also take some medicines which will suppress their immunity. So that those people are called as the immunocompromised people, because the contaminants like viruses or bacteria can become attached to the suspended solids. Then what do you mean by BOD, or the biochemical oxygen demand? The biochemical oxygen demand is the amount of oxygen which is required to remove the waste organic matter from water in the process of decomposition by aerobic bacteria, those bacteria that live only in an environment containing oxygen. The third question is, what is water pollution? Water pollution can be defined as a harmful substances such as chemicals or microorganisms which contaminate the water streams, river, lake, ocean, aquifers, or any other water body, degrading the water quality and rendering it to toxic for the human consumption and for the environment. Then what are the causes of water pollution? There are n number of water causes for the water pollution, out of which I have enlisted few, that is the industrial waste, sewage and water, wastewater, mining activities, marine dumping, accidental oil spillage, the burning of fossil fuels, chemical fertilizers and pesticides, leakage from the sewer lines. So this was the topics that we were discussing with respect to, rather than topics, these are the questions which are expected from the experiment. So you are supposed to write these answers in your biology practical notebook meant for 12th standard. So this was the experiment. If you have any doubts, please write in the comment section. Thank you.